Hi, it's Carrie. I'm the health professions librarian at Towson University's Cook Library. In this video, I'm going to show you my tips and tricks for finding evidence-based literature. So often, when you're looking for literature, you're probably going to find a lot of publications that aren't suitable evidence, like editorials and case reports. But when you're looking for evidence-based literature, you'll need to be laser-focused on evidence, things like studies, trials, guidelines, and meta-syntheses in your topic of interest. David Sackett, in his seminal article, Evidence-Based Medicine, What It Is and What It Isn't, stated that evidence-based medicine is the conscientious, explicit, and judicious use of current best evidence in making decisions about the care of individual patients. Evidence-based practice has come to be recognized as integrating research evidence with clinical expertise and patient preferences and values. So we have to look for the research evidence. You may be familiar with the evidence-based medicine pyramid. There are a couple of different versions, but usually you'll find secondary research like systematic reviews, meta-analyses, and clinical practice guidelines near the top, because these are syntheses of study data. Primary studies like randomized controlled trials and controlled clinical trials toward the middle, and narrative reviews and expert opinion toward the bottom. First, when you're looking for evidence-based literature, it may be helpful to frame your topic into a PICO format, that is, patient, problem or population, intervention or exposure, comparison or control, and outcomes. Don't worry if you don't have all the elements here yet. This is just to help you get started. In fact, it's better if you start your search broadly, with search terms that define the patient, problem, or population, and search terms that describe the intervention or exposure. Next, it's time to look for the evidence. My favorite place to start is PubMed, a platform from the U.S. National Library of Medicine that has three major components: Medline, a bibliographic database with references from journal articles in life and biomedical sciences; PubMed Central, the free full-text archive of biomedical and life sciences journal literature at the National Library of Medicine; and the NCBI bookshelf, containing books and documents in life sciences and healthcare. When you search in PubMed, you're searching all of these components: Medline, PubMed Central, and the NCBI bookshelf. You can get to PubMed through the Cook Library's A to Z database list. This will give you access to full-text PDFs when we have them. Alternatively, PubMed is freely available on the web, but some of its content may not be, so I recommend accessing it through your library or institution if possible. You can conduct your search in the simple search bar or from the advanced search option. Remember my tips and tricks like using quotes around phrases. Let's say we were looking for evidence for the effectiveness of occupational therapy after stroke. I'm going to enter occupational therapy in quotes, use the Boolean operator and enter stroke. This tells PubMed to find us literature that contains both of these terms. Wow, look at those results! But we don't want everything that's ever been written. We want literature that would be considered a high level of evidence, the research evidence. Notice that on the left, there are lots of different filters. If you don't see what you want, scroll down and click on Additional Filters. For an evidence-based search, we want to focus on article type. What we want to see is the option to limit to meta-analysis, systematic review, clinical trial, and practice guideline under article type. If you're looking for something in particular, you may decide to filter through the article types one at a time. For instance, if I only wanted to see systematic reviews, I could uncheck the other options. My results would be limited then to only systematic reviews. Click on any record to be directed to the full text options through the Find It button for Towson affiliates, or other full text options. Next, let's look at Trip Database. You can access Trip Database on the web or through the Cook Library's A to Z database list. Trip is also a freely available resource. Let's try our search again. Occupational therapy, in quotes, and stroke. On the left-hand side, you'll see filters for systematic reviews, guidelines by country, and primary and secondary research. Click on any record to see your options for accessing the full-text PDF. In short, when you're looking for evidence-based literature, you'll want to keep an idea of some version of the evidence-based medicine pyramid in mind. That way, you'll be able to filter your results for higher levels of research evidence like systematic reviews, meta-analyses, clinical practice guidelines, randomized controlled trials, and more. I hope that you were able to learn something new from this video. Leave a comment down below and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you find it helpful. Librarians are here to help, and I would be thrilled to hear from you.